Good morning students, myself Ajit Pratap Singh. Today in this video of class 8 science, I'll let you know about manures, fertilizers. Okay, apart from this, I'll let you know about process of manuring, crop rotation. And apart from this, I'll explain some other things also. In the previous video, I told you about how or in how many parts the crops are divided according to the seasons. So as I told you, crops were divided according to the seasons in three parts, that is in kharif crops, rabi crops and jayad crops. Okay, and apart from this, I also told you about the methods of crop production. In this, preparation of the soil was the first step. So today I'll start from the manuring. In the preparation of the soil, as I told you, we need a plow or we need a seed drill also, right? And apart from this, the sowing of seed using a seed drill was also there. So today I'll start from manuring. As we all know, students, that plants require nutrients for their proper growth, okay, and they get nutrients from the soil. Therefore, as soon as the crop is harvested, it has taken away some of the nutrients present in the soil. Okay, so whenever the crop is harvested, some of the nutrients diminish into the soil or decrease into the soil. Because of this, the nutrients get used up if land is cultivated for a long time. This causes the crop yield to start falling. Therefore, these nutrients need to be replenished from time to time. Or we can say the supply of nutrients at the regular interval of time is very much required. This can be done by some natural methods or by adding manures and fertilizers also into the soil. Okay students, some natural methods of manuring are, first one is field fallow. One way of allowing land to naturally regain the nutrients is to leave it free for one or more season. Means if we will not sow any seed, then it will automatically regain the nutrients. Dead plants and animals and other organic matter that collect on the land are decomposed by the microbes. Thus, the nutrients are returned to the soil. So this is how we can regain the nutrients into the soil. Next method is crop rotation. This is also a method of manuring naturally. Each crop uses more of some nutrients and less of others. Farmers therefore change their crop into the seasons or in each season so that the soil is not depleted of any particular nutrient, so that there is no depletion of any particular nutrient into the soil. So this method is known as crop rotation. Different type of crops are grown in different seasons. So this is how crop rotation take place. For example, wheat or rice uses up large amount of nitrogen from the soil. This nitrogen can be naturally replenished into the soil. The next crop grown is that of a legume like pea or groundnut. You have already read in class 7 that bacteria called rhizobium that are present in the root nodules of the root of leguminous plants, they can fix atmospheric nitrogen to form water soluble nitrogen compounds. Okay, this soil, the soil is then ready for the next wheat or rice crop. Next one is mixed cropping. Sometimes two or more crops are grown together in the same field, then the crops are chosen in such a way that by nutrients needs one of crops that are fulfilled by another. Okay, any leguminous crop such as peas, soya beans or green beans and a cereal crop like wheat or rice can be grown together in the same field for the season. Cotton and groundnut crops are also often grown together. However, these natural methods alone are not enough to maintain the fertility of the soil. So that's why the farmers have to use the fertilizers or manures time to time. Okay, students, now the next slide. By using the fertilizers and manures, first of all, manures are organic substances obtained from dead plants and animals' wastes. Green manure is made from crops grown specifically to be plowed into the soil while still green. Legumes, ryegrass, fenugreek, etc. to improve the fertility of the soil. Animal manure consists of animal waste. Compost is a manure obtained by the decomposition of dead plants and animal waste. Okay. Compost is made by burying all available organic material in a pit with alternative layer of soil and leaving it to rot. Bacteria and fungi in the layers of the soil speed up the decomposition process. And compost is rich in organic nutrients but not in some important nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. Fertilizers are human-made chemical substances that contain one or more nutrients essential for plant growth. The most frequently used fertilizers are NPK fertilizers that are rich in nitrogen, potassium and phosphorus salts. They are very easy to store and handle since they are soluble in water. Okay, these are directly absorbed by plants and green and greatly increase crop yields. However, if overused, fertilizers harm the soil also because they make them porous. Excess fertilizers get washed into water bodies and harm aquatic animals. Fertilizers are prepared in factories, but manure can be prepared in fields. Therefore, farmers normally use a combination of manures and fertilizers. Okay, students. So that's it. Now, I am hopeful that you will be able to tell about manures, fertilizers in detail, and what are the benefits of manuring into the soil, and what are the main fertilizers which are supposed to be used into the soil. Okay, or what are the main salts like nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium which are important as the or in the fertilizers. Okay, but excess use is also not good for the plants for sure. So now you will be able to tell about everything in detail. That's it in this video. Have a great day.